The United Nations expects 70% of the world population to live in cities by the year 2050. The accelerating process of urbanization poses inconceivable challenges for governments and planning professionals in the management of urban space. Already in our times, a silent war is raging in cities around the world, a fierce battle for scarce urban spaces. Different stakeholders compete for their specific use of land or urban space. In these battles, all too often, nature and food production cannot stand up to the competition with residential areas and space for infrastructures. In this video, we will explore this battle in more detail. We will demonstrate that urban planning is more than just a technical rational task in the hands of professionals in spatial planning. Planning processes inherently involve a political dimension. Different stakeholders co-determine what the urban environment will look like in the future. In planning manuals, the Netherlands are often portrayed as a planner's paradise. The use of space is carefully designed, planning follows strict rules and blueprints. But even in this alleged paradise for planners, green and urban agriculture very often fall victim to excessive urbanization and uncontrolled competition for urban spaces. Why does this happen? Let's look at a brief history of urban planning. Competition for land uses in urban areas is nothing new. For centuries, governments all over the world have used their powers to safeguard space for roads, canals, squares, parks and public buildings. Architects, engineers, surveyors, lawyers and bankers offered their services to create proper drawings, ground plans, laws and financial resources for spatial planning. In the 19th century, a process of professionalization of urban planning and landscape design took off in most Western countries. In the 20th century, urban planning transformed into a new branch of government, designated as spatial planning. At the heart of spatial planning is the allocation of land for conflicting land uses. Spatial planning is perceived predominantly as a rational technical task for planning professionals. The leading principle of professional planning was formulated by the Scottish biologist and planner Patrick Geddes as follows: for everything a place, everything in its place. In the paradigm of rational planning, urban planning follows two phases. First, professional architects and engineers lay out the playground of viable developments and the consequences of different scenarios of land use. And second, this information is fed into a process of political decision making. The first stage is assumed to make the second stage proceed easier and more realistic. And in this paradigm, it is expected that once an allocation plan is determined, it will be executed without much ado. But what this technical and top-down planning paradigm fails to recognize is the fact that the process is too often distorted by politics, power, and capital. I will illustrate this by the case of Buttercup Farm. Buttercup Farm is a so-called care farm situated in the western outskirts of Amsterdam. And in the 1990s, the future looked bright for this farm, a farm where socially and psychologically vulnerable people produced certified organic vegetables. The land of Buttercup Farm is owned by the municipality of Amsterdam. It was acquired in the 1950s, preceding the implementation of a town extension plan. In the year 2000, a private company bought 8 hectares of land near the farm for €2.3 million. This is way above the price of agricultural land. 9 years later, the same parcel was resold to the municipality for €8 million, plus development rights for an office park. Journalists were alarmed by critical citizens concerned about the quality of their neighborhood. investigative journalism revealed bribery and corruption in the municipal apparatus. And an alderman for spatial planning was convicted in court because of his role in giving preferential treatment to developers. Between 2000 and 2009, the price of land in the area of Buttercup Farm increased to a level tenfold the price of agricultural land. In 2008, the municipality attempted to terminate the leasehold contract for the Buttercup Farm. At the time, this attempt failed because a citizen initiative collected 14,000 signatures and managed to mobilize political support for continuing the agricultural use of land. In the eyes of citizen activists, a green oasis was being sacrificed on the altar of profitable commercial development at the expense of nature, food production, and their quality of life. Recently, however, it was decided by the municipal authorities to bring down Buttercup Farm. The farm should make room for the concrete blocks of a business park to replace the organic vegetables. What this case tells us is that decisions on the use of urban space do not just follow from rational technical planning procedures enacted by planning experts, but citizens and other stakeholders engage in a sometimes fierce struggle for their preferred uses of land, for their dreams about the future of a particular part of urban space. What do you think? What is more decisive for the sustainable use of urban space? The paradigm of rational technical planning or the power struggles of different stakeholders? Or perhaps both?